Great. All right. So it's Joey Remenyi here from Seeking Balance Australia. And I have got a very special client with me. So I've got Sue, who's going to talk through a case study. My intention in sharing these video case studies is that through storytelling and through sharing our humanity of what we feel and what we experience and how we move from A to B, I find that there's a healing and a connection, you know, that we're developing community and understanding for others and for ourselves. So Sue's been really brave and she is an inspirational woman. So I'm really glad that Sue's here on video and we're going to have a chat. So welcome, Sue.
Hello.
So my first question, Sue, is I want you to think back to when you were really in that pain point and tell people who are listening is what were you feeling at the time when you somehow got referred to me and you found Seeking Balance. So just talk through that initial part of your story.
Yeah. So it was about 6 months ago, so in June, and it really started when I became aware of some ringing in the ears. I was particularly aware of it at a night time in bed. It started to disturb my sleep. I've had that sort of ringing in my ears before, but not to this degree. Around that time, I'd had some difficult news, professional news about my work situation. So there was a lot of stress building up in my life, and I realized quite quickly that the tinnitus was, a symptom of the stress that I was going through. And then ultimately, I experienced quite a high level of anxiety around that time. It wasn't a very comfortable feeling, I have to say.
Yes. I remember when we first met. So was it the GP who suggested that you try me, or did you find me on the internet, or I can't remember? How did you come across Seeking Balance?
Yeah. Well, I actually, funnily enough, when I first saw your business, it was actually at the audiologist's office in Torquay. So I went to get my ears checked. That all came out normal. My results were quite normal. He did say I had some hearing loss in my right ear, just a small amount of hearing loss in my right ear, but nothing to worry about. But he also said if you are concerned, he referred me on to a hearing specialist.
Or an ear, nose and throat surgeon?
Ear, nose and throat surgeon, yeah.
Yeah, so you did the... that's right. And so your ENT, now I remember. So you went through the medical route and you spoke to your GP, the audiologist for hearing test purposes, and then the ENT to look at the medical aspects. And then you were still heart palpitations and feeling really strange, and you ended up deciding to work with me.
And
I, of course, said to you, I work over a period of 4 to 6 months. Is this something you feel that you want or need? And what made you decide to enter a process? So the Beautiful Balance private client process, what made you decide that for yourself?
Look, I'm always open to different types of healing and treatment. I'm a big believer in holistic healing. Yep. I've practice meditation on and off over the years, and I know how powerful and useful that is. Mm-hmm. And I think when I saw your flyer at the audiologist, it just really resonated with me. I think Seeking Balance, I really liked the title of it because it sounded quite holistic, the title of your business. And it wasn't just about, you know, it's not just medical, it's a different approach to healing. And I think that's where your approach is quite unique, because I don't think there's anything else really like it as far as I know.
No, there's not much out there yet, but I'm looking to train more professionals in this, so there will be. Hold that thought. So I'm curious to know, what were your expectations? So I suppose how were you feeling in yourself, in your confidence? And you said you'd had this work hiccup, so suddenly work wasn't flowing anymore, so you would have had some financial concern. And then you're not sleeping well, you've got the anxiety, you don't really understand the tinnitus, all the medical world saying it's normal.
Yeah.
And, And then you've suddenly signed up, you've invested in yourself to do a 4 or 6 month process. God knows what you expected. What was that process like for you? Were your expectations met? And what results did, like, what benefits did you feel for yourself? So talk people through
that. Honestly, didn't really know what to expect, you know, because I'd never worked with you before. But I always think, look, you know, what price for good health? There's no price for good health. And I think if you're able to make an investment in improving your health, then, you know, it's a no-brainer to me why you would question not moving forward with that. And I also like the fact that you did offer a sort of a cooling off period so that, you know, we'll see how you and I would get on at the start. And, you know, if there was a connection and I could sort of anticipate that we were going to work well together, that you had stuff to offer me, then, you know, we could continue. Or
and talk through those benefits. Like, how do you know? Like, it's all like, how do you know that it's feeling good for you? What were the benefits? So you were feeling kind of the sleeplessness and anxiety, and then what happened?
Yeah, I think it's just the fact that the thing I liked about working with you, Joey, was that you had the medical knowledge, because I know you're a trained audiologist yourself, mm-hmm. but you also had this other approach of the holistic approach, that it's all about your mind really, and how your mind and neuroplasticity and how your brain is responding to the things that are going on in your body.
The body and the brain working as a team. Yeah,
absolutely. And, you know, I've personally had some experience of, I've read about neuroplasticity, so I've got a bit of understanding of it already. And I just liked that approach. And I felt that you'd gave me strategies to think about the tinnitus in a different way, you know, not catastrophize about it. So I think that's, you know, some of the lines or advice that you gave me just really resonated, and they were just helpful.
Do you remember how long you had to wait until you felt a benefit? Was it like, you know, immediate relief, or was it like it just slowly dropped into place week after week?
I think initially I had a good positive feeling about it. I felt hopeful that I would receive some benefit from you. And I think you've got to go into these things with an open mind.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah.
And an open heart. And you go, okay, take on what's going to work for me. Maybe not all of it was applicable to me, but apply what is useful and take on what's useful. And it obviously has, I really feel it has contributed to my healing over the last few months. I feel like it's got me back into that zone of listening to my body more, being more aware of my body, and also appreciating the power of meditation, of mindfulness, and just sitting with things and knowing that, you know, things will resolve themselves.
It really
has been a great journey.
It's quite miraculous, isn't it? Once you sort of go from A to B, at the time it can feel so impossible and so painful and, you know, so helpless. And then when you go through these logical little steps and tune into what you need, because like you said, it's not a generic one size fits all for everybody. There's going to be bits and pieces that are relevant each moment or each day. So now that you've kind of, would you say you've arrived? Or how do you feel in your body now?
I definitely think I'm feeling a lot better, a lot better than I have. I think, I actually think I've learned a lot over this process of just, you know, that whole thing of just letting go and just being in the moment. And I think that's really important. And, you know, I still sometimes, I'm much more aware of when the symptoms do pop up every now and then.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm thinking, okay, what, it's almost like they're a sort of alarm bell. Okay, you're looking after yourself. You know, are you putting good food into your body? How's your exercise going? You know, how's your sort of, spiritual world looking, or your sort of meditation world looking? Are you doing enough of that? Are you doing enough of just the calming down and just being in the moment? And I find when I get caught up in, you know, everyday stresses of life, sometimes things that are quite big might be happening, that it's so easy to fall into that sort of stress cycle again.
Yeah.
And so, I'm learning to sort of, what's the word?
Interrupt that. Yeah.
Yeah. You just sort of recognize it and go, okay, no, I don't want to go down that path again. I don't need to do that.
You've got tools.
And just bring yourself back. So I think, I do think the Seeking Balance has provided me with some tools to do that. And just the support that I, you know, got from Joey over the last few months. And just her really sensible advice and just saying, okay, she reflects back to you. Well, what is going on? You know, what's going on, Sue?
Even when it's hard.
Yeah, and it can be challenging, but, you know, it's just it's like someone giving you a reality check and saying, well, what do you need to make your life better?
And my last question will be around, have you noticed your relationship to yourself has changed? So you've mentioned you're listening to yourself more and learning how to move, roll with the punches. So listen, check what you need, and then use the skills and tools you've learned to implement that. But have you noticed with your relationship to your job, your relationship to, where you live, your relationship to your family, have you noticed any changes to your relationship to the world? So this idea of actually seeing things differently and being a different player, what have you noticed in that?
Oh, I think so. I think I'm not taking myself nearly as seriously as I had been. I'm much more connected with people now. Like, I've moved from a rural coastal environment, which was beautiful but a bit isolating. I've moved to the city. Mm-hmm. I'm reconnecting with family, friends up here. I've established work opportunities up here.
Yep.
The world is a lot bigger for me now. I think, really connecting with people.
Feel your confidence might have changed?
Oh, I think so. Yeah, I think I'm more trusting of myself that I can get through things, you know.
So there's a resilience. Yeah.
Come along. So the resilience. Yeah, I think this process has really helped me build up some resilience, you know.
So if we go back to the beginning when it was like, you know, oh my God, what's happening? And I've seen the doctor and I've seen the surgeon and it's still there. And like, I'm trying to remember back to our very first sessions. Was there a moment then when you thought, oh my God, maybe I can't work, you know, I can't function, I can't sleep, I can't think clearly, like my life is, this is a big problem. Was there that breaking point?
Definitely had that sense of, it's almost a sense of despair. It is a bit, and you feel a bit hopeless, you know, you feel...
It's so confusing.
I'm just not coping. Like, I just felt like I wasn't coping. And
well, look at you now.
What I did was reach out for help. And that's what you have to do. If you feel like you're not, you're overwhelmed and you're not coping with life, and you have to ask for help. You have to reach out for help. Yeah. And there's, believe me, help out there, you know. And Joey was one of a few things I put in place. And she was a really important part of that to get back on track.
Yeah. And it's funny because it reminds me when I had it. So when I had my, you know, vertigo and tinnitus, and I was working at Melbourne Uni. So, I mean, I had so much academic knowledge at my fingertips, but there was that kind of emotional hole of, who do you talk to? Like, how do you, it's distressing, right? And how do you get skills and tools in daily life to actually have confidence and to relax and to trust your body? And I felt like no one was really offering that. So in essence, I created the support that I wanted and that I couldn't find.
Yeah.
So that's kind of like my story and how I fit into it.
Yeah. Brilliant. Yeah.
Well, it's been a pleasure working with you, Sue. So, I mean, I just think I have the best job in the world. So congratulations for being you and backing yourself and going through the process. You've obviously got the Rocksteady resources to keep. So you can tap into them and you'll have my voice in your ears anytime you press play. But I wanted to just thank you for sharing your story, for your humility, and it's really brave to be on video. So it's a pleasure to see your journey.
Glad to have been able to do that, and I think it's a good process for me to do it too.